Home is the only place which protects us from every harmful element like sunlight, strong winds, bad colds. We think that home is the safest place to live. But what if I say even our indoor air contains higher concentration of toxins? Yes, this is completely true. In this video, I'm going to talk about most of the harmful pollutants, chemicals, and also the sources from which they get emitted into our indoor air. So please keep watching this video completely. Hello guys, welcome back to Trust Basket. As many of you recommended to make video on air purifying plants, here I am. In YouTube, there are many videos about air purifying plants and also about the chemicals which they remove from air. But I feel there is also another important point which we need to consider. It is sources. Knowing the sources from which these pollutants getting introduced into our home is also very important to find any solution for it. By knowing this, we can reduce the use of those entities and also we can grow plants according to it. So, shall we start? Okay, I told you that indoor air also contains many harmful chemicals and pollutants. I think it will be a little difficult for you to believe it. Let me clear this. According to World Health Organization, around 4.3 million people are dying annually just because of household air pollution. And the main reason for this pollution is burning of traditional fuels like cow dung, charcoal, firewood for cooking purposes. It may be our culture to use all these traditional fuels, but when we say it scientifically, this burning leads to smoke that contains many harmful elements like particulate matter, carbon monoxide, nitrous oxide, sulfur dioxide, which are very harmful to our health and to our environment as well. The most affected people by these chemicals are women and children, as they spend most of their time indoors. This is why women and children of villages are more prone to lung cancers, heart strokes, and also to some pulmonary disorders. So this is all about traditional fuels, which are main source of indoor air pollution. And the other sources of this pollution are products, things which we generally use in our homes for different purposes. All these things emit many harmful chemicals like benzene, xylene, toluene, formaldehyde, which at higher concentration cause many health problems in us. So let's see some of the sources and also the chemicals which they emit into our indoor air. Benzene, xylene, toluene are mainly emitted by the burning of organic materials like wood, coal and petroleum products like kerosene. Even tobacco also results in these emissions. But there is also another thing which we need to know about it. Tobacco smoke contains more than 7,000 chemicals, out of which 70 are carcinogens. It means 70 chemicals can cause cancers in humans. So by this you might have understood to which extent tobacco pollutes our indoor air. Even our dry clean clothes act as sources for many chemicals like trichloroethylene and perchloroethylene. While paints, sealants, resins, glues, which we generally use in our home, contains formaldehyde, which is another serious pollutant of air. It is even classified as human carcinogen by World Health Organization. Due to this toxicity, it is even banned in USA and also in some other countries. There are some group of chemicals which actually escapes into the air and pollutes it. As these chemicals get evaporated, we call them as volatile organic compounds. Even previously mentioned chemicals are also included in this group. Apart from those, these chemicals are present in almost everything which we use in our homes, like carpets, wooden furnishings, electronics, deodorants, plastics, and also in cleaning products. At higher concentration, these chemicals may also lead to health problems like eye irritations, headaches, and also respiratory disorders. So these are some of the sources and chemicals which pollutes our indoor air. And we have to protect ourselves from these harmful chemicals. I don't think using of chemical sprays or products is a permanent solution for it, because it is not just the matter of 1 week or a month, right? So I feel growing of indoor plants is the only organic solution to reduce the concentration of these chemicals in our household air. I suggest indoor plants because, like how trees purify the outdoor air, indoor plants can help in purifying the indoor air. It is even proved by NASA in their research study and finally recommended few plants which can actually purify the air. So let's know what are they. Aloe vera, spider plant, snake plant, rubber plant, peace lily, ZZ, Boston fern. Like this, there are many plants that can actually purify air. And the best part of all these plants is we can place them anywhere in our home, like balconies, any corners, tabletops. Like I said, we can place them anywhere. So let's get into some more details of all these plants. So first let's talk about areca palm, which you can see in the background, and this beautiful rubber plant. These two plants can remove the carbon dioxide more efficiently. Actually, every plant does this, but what I come to say is these two plants can remove carbon dioxide in higher amounts when compared to other plants. So let's first talk about this areca palm. So other than carbon dioxide, this areca palm also removes some harmful chemicals like formaldehyde, xylene and toluene. And it is very easy to care this areca palm. All we need to do is we should keep it in an indirect light, something like this. Or you can also place this plant in your balconies where it receives morning or evening sunlight. Actually, there won't be any major problems in growing this areca palm, but sometimes this leaves shows browning tips, and this happens mainly due to overwatering. So for any plants, we need to water them only when the top 1 or 2 inches becomes dry. By that, we can avoid many problems like brown tips, yellowing and rotting as well. So this is all about caring of areca palm. And when it comes to rubber plant, this plant can survive in wide range of lights. So you can also keep this plant in your bedrooms because it does well even in dim lights. As this plant is hardy, it can survive in any type of lights. And when it comes to its leaves, they have very beautiful and shiny leaves. So I assure you that this plant definitely adds beauty to your rooms. So now let's talk about snake plant, money plant and aglaonema. All these plants are also efficient air purifiers that they can remove formaldehyde and benzene along with xylene and toluene type of chemicals. Like rubber plant, these plants can also survive in medium to low light conditions. Especially this snake plant. This plant can survive in direct light, indirect light and also in low light conditions. And the unique feature of this plant is it can release oxygen during nights. Generally, all plants release carbon dioxide during nights, but you no need to worry because their concentration will not harm any humans or pets. So what I come to say is you can maintain snake plants in your bedroom if you have any sleeping or breathing disorders. So this plant actually tops my favorite list because this plant have different shape and pattern of leaves, which makes it so unique when compared to other plants. So I can say this is my favorite plant. What's yours? Do comment and let me know what's your favorite plant along with the reason why you like it most. So here comes another super plant, that is spider plant. This plant can eliminate carbon monoxide from air, and you can maintain it as a tabletop plant when it is small and young. And when it starts producing plantlets like this, you can just keep it in hanging baskets because these long trailing stems and their falling leaves looks very much better in hanging baskets. So our next plant is this aloe vera plant. We all know aloe vera for its medicinal properties, but this plant is also an air purifier. It can eliminate benzene, formaldehyde that mainly comes from detergents. So as it is a succulent plant, we need to maintain it near to window so that it gets good amount of sunlight. And when it comes to watering, you no need to worry because this plant do well even if you water it for once a week. While lady palm is another air purifying plant that can survive anywhere in your home, like hall, bedroom or even in your bathrooms, because this plant can do fine anywhere. But the only thing which we need to care is watering. As this is the water loving plant, we need to water it regularly. So here comes another two water loving air purifying plants, which are peace lily and boston fern. Both these plants love moisture. So we need to keep their soil always moist to keep the leaves straight without falling or drooping. So far we have discussed about a lot of air purifying indoor plants, and there are also a lot more. Say English ivy, ZZ plant, weeping fig, and this list goes on. Actually, maintaining all these indoor plants is very easy, and they are also easily available in any nursery around you. So in addition to maintaining all these plants, you should also follow some regular measures to keep your indoor air clean. So let's get into those details. The first and foremost thing is quitting smoking. At least we should not allow people to smoke indoors. and the rest are the regular ones like maintaining proper ventilation throughout our home, using organic cleaning products and avoiding chemical sprays like deodorants, insect repellents, pesticides and not allowing footwear inside. And the other important thing is, we should also reduce the use of air conditioners in our home because they result in emitting of chlorofluorocarbons which are very harmful to us and to our environment. So these are some of the measures which we need to follow to keep our indoor air clean. So this is all about today's video. Thanks for watching. Catch you in next video with some more interesting topic. Until then, stay tuned to Trust Basket. Bye bye.